So far, she doesn't really seem to be getting the concept of walking on a leash right now.
How many of you deal with this with your puppy?
I'm Zach George. I'm a dog trainer. Meet my new project, Kona. I've got just 3 weeks to train her and set her up for the most well-behaved life possible. That means I need to work on the most common puppy issues like potty training, how to actually pay attention, stopping things like play biting, chewing, separation anxiety, getting along with other animals, leash walking, and teaching her everything a good dog needs to know. Real dog training doesn't always go smoothly, and that's why I'm going to show you every success and mistake and how I work through all of the most challenging parts of raising a new puppy.
Welcome to your new puppy survival guide.
I've been continuing to work with Kona on actually going to sleep while in her crate overnight. And as you can see, as soon as I walk out of sight with Kona, it's apparent that she's definitely more anxious. She immediately starts vocalizing. This is really representative of the nuanced moments in training where you really have to be patient and understanding with your dog. In this situation, there are both pros and cons to letting Kona express her anxiety for a period of time. And the same is true if I let her out of her crate too. But in this case, I feel like Kona's anxiety isn't so severe, and I think I can test for 10 or 15 minutes or so. But if Kona's still barking after 15 minutes, this is when I reconsider letting her out to pee or have some water or maybe offer her some extra food or a great dog chew. Well, Kona still seemed pretty upset after 15 minutes in this case, and to be fair, it is only her third night here. So I did elect to sleep downstairs to hopefully help her feel more comfortable. Knowing when to let your dog cry and when to give in and let them out or sleep with them requires a lot of testing, and this is how you do it. So you guys saw how last night went. I mean, it didn't exactly go as planned, and it's important to remain flexible at all times when you're training a dog, because dog training in its purest form is catering to the individual dog that you're working with. I thought it would be good to sleep on the couch because the last two nights I was sleeping right here on a mattress. This puts me a little bit farther away, and she seemed to do fine. So I consider even that progress. I was just trying to take a step that was too big. Another thing that's been proving very useful is the Furbo. You can see we've had it set up there since day one. If you're wondering about the bark alerts, let me assure you they work very well. And these were just from last night. You can see you can select all the barking shots, the continuous barking shots. Check this out though. Look, the howling shots. Hear that? It just trips me out how Furbo knows the difference between barking and howling, but you can see there, really clear example of her anxiety. And moving forward, I know Furbo is gonna be very beneficial to us because as I am able to get upstairs and monitor her, it'll give me more information on what to do and how to proceed. I'm gonna distribute a treat here. I'm just gonna press this. See if it gets her attention. What's that? What? Look at all those treats. There are so many creative ways to use this feature in your training. I'm gonna have a link in the description where you can pick one up. Leash walking is an essential skill for our dogs, but it's far from natural for them to understand how to behave when they're on a leash. In general, dogs aren't used to always being within 4 or 6 feet of us that the leash requires them to be in. For example, there she is. Kona! She's doing great there, good job. But when a dog is on the leash and they're not used to it, they very often will lag behind and get fixated on something on the ground, or they'll pull ahead or try and get at any number of things. In other words, it's not really intuitive for them to just walk next to us really nicely. So we have to teach them that. The first time that we put a leash on a dog, don't just assume they're going to be accepting of it. I think Kona's gonna be pretty good here. You just wanna place it on there and let them get used to wearing the leash. They can even walk around. You see, she's even chewing it. I don't like that, but I'm gonna pick my battles here. It's more important that she not be nervous of the leash. If you come on too strong with a leash, you're likely to scare your dog a little bit, and it's always best to avoid that if we can. Just for good measure, make sure they're comfortable dragging it around like that. You can see she's not thrown off by that in the slightest, so we're pretty good. Let's see how she does when there's tension applied to the leash, because they're often going to lunge and pull. But see, if we introduce the concept of tension, yes, in a really mild way, we can ease them into the fact that, hey, sometimes there's gonna be tension, especially with a puppy, because you guys are crazy. There we go, nice. Watch what I'm doing here. I'm just giving a little bit of tension and giving her a treat, saying, hey, look, tension happens, no big deal. To be clear here, I'm preparing her for tension only because puppies are likely
to be very rambunctious and experience it, and I don't want it to scare her. The leash is not a tool for actually training your dog or providing a negative consequence, but it's just a way to easily control your dog. The first leash walking session with any dog should be in an indoor, familiar environment. That's why we're here in my living room right now. The reason we want to be indoors is that it's a lot less distracting than outdoors. So we want to make first lessons as easy as possible in everything that we do. You might remember in our last lesson, we focused on look at me, right? Here, look at me. So leash walking is essentially look at me while we walk around. I mean, I generally want to make sure that I can get her attention on me while we're moving. That's what we're trying to teach. This very basic concept. You can see right off the bat, she's already pulling ahead. My objective is to get her paying attention to me just while we walk around. So, Kona, sit, look at me. Good girl. Great start. Just trying to see if I can get her into a natural flow. I don't want to pull her along. Good, yes. Here, what's this? Every time she bites at the leash like that, I'm just going to encourage her to look at me and let go of the leash just by holding up the treat or making a high-pitched voice or getting her attention in some happy way. She looks a little bored right now, doesn't she? Like, she doesn't seem like she really wants to do a leash walking session. So I've got a couple of options. I guess I could take a break, but I don't want to do that. I'm in the mood to train you. So let me see if I can inspire her to go along with this lesson. I like that, man. See, the value of play. You can see how she's just lit up here. She doesn't seem quite as bored. Food isn't the only kind of currency for a dog. Play, like this, can serve as a way to reward your dog, but we want to be really strategic. So ideally, we work up to 3 to 5 second sessions of tug of war or a single toss of the toy and bringing it back so that we can keep the training session going. Come here, let's go. Good, right there. Look at that nice little trot. Come on, let's go. Just using the toy to kind of signal her along, getting that eye line up here. Good girl. Go ahead and let her chase the toy for a second, get some engagement. Good girl. Maybe I'll let her play with it a little extra long here since it's a new concept for her. Good, yeah. Nice job. What? Good, okay, good. Yes, look at you. Good. Easy. I want to be really careful not to reward the jumping, and so I really am only going to reward good leash walking. You can see she's used to getting treated for lie down, so she's like, hey, maybe that'll get me what I want. Come on. So far, she doesn't really seem to be getting the concept of walking on a leash right now, but she does like playing. So, I mean, this is normal, you know? Leash walking sessions can be bumpy like this, especially when they're new. All I'm doing here is looking for opportunities to acknowledge general attention or eye contact. Look at that, look at the look. Yes. Good. So right there, I got her to look up at me and make that turn while we were walking on a leash. Wanted to let her know there were good things coming after she complied with that request. Go. Here. Kona! Okay, I'm struggling a little bit here, and I'm not really getting the steady focus I was hoping for. Kona, come on, keep moving, keep moving. Here we go. When I get more peppy, she does too, but that also increases her playful leash biting. Ultimately, I want her eyes off of that leash and onto me during training like this. Here. Yes, good. She's really fascinated with the leash right now. Every time she goes for that leash, Kona, sit. Yes, giving her that incompatible thing to do. Let me see if she wants a treat now. We can always mix it up, see what she prefers. Kona, come on. Yeah, we go, and I'm, you know, give her some water here, take a water break. I'm gonna look for moments where she's looking up at me and not jumping. Yes, just like that. I love that little prance that she's doing. Come on, keep moving. Good girl. Let's go up this way. Come on. You want to really start to get your best version of leash walking inside the house. It is orders of magnitude more difficult to teach a dog to walk like this in an outdoor or public environment than it is inside. That's because their senses are just overwhelmed, especially as young dogs, when they go to a new place. Here. Yes. Good, and I'm pairing the word here, which you could say look at me, you could say watch me, whatever. I mean, those attention-getting words can be used in different contexts however you want to use them. So I'm getting sustained attention here.
Yes.
Like that.
Indoor leash walking is looking pretty good, but the outdoors can be way more challenging. I'm gonna give Kona a break and then let's take her outside and see how she does. Now, before we do this next leash walking lesson, let's go give her a potty break. She's been taking a nap for a little while. It's not good enough to work on one thing at a time, really. We're working on many things simultaneously. Go pee. Yes. Okay, let's put that leash on. Like before, we're gonna get her warmed up with a look at me. Oh, didn't even have to ask for it. You're just that smart, aren't you? Good job, girl. Nice. Can you give me a stand? Yeah, good work. Love it. Now, right here, I'm just basically testing for general compliance, a sit. Can we get it down? Yep, we sure can. Good girl. Yes, okay. Good work. We're staying at the house here, because this is going to be an easier environment. Even though it's outdoors, it's an easier outdoor environment than going to a big city where she hasn't been, for example. She's spent a lot of time out here. She's quite familiar with this particular outdoor environment, but all outdoor environments are not equal. I like her energy right now. I don't really care which side she walks on.
Yes. The main thing is that she's just like, hey, what's going on? I wanna walk with you.
Yes, good. And so, I mean, do you see her general willingness right here? To pay attention, how she's looking over there. Now she's looking up here.
Yes.
She even slowed down and sat there. That's a good sign. I mean, that's the thing about leash walking. You just want them paying attention to you instead of everything around them. And that's why you want to keep the environment really easy at first, because puppies are very curious beings and will easily get distracted. Wow, look at this. And here I'm able to get some sustained walking. I'm gonna try to turn around and see what she does. Yep, there she goes.
Yes.
Good work. Good work. Boy, this is one good first leash training session. Let's see what happens when we change textures and walk on the grass here. How does she do there? A little more distracted. I mean, the smell of grass is very enticing to dogs.
Hey, Kona.
See that? Look, see how she's lagging behind all of a sudden? Just changing the texture can make a huge difference. Kona.
Yes.
Let me go ahead and reward her for just taking a few steps toward me. So if your dog was lagging behind or they got fixated on something, just be patient, wait it out. See if you can coax them and encourage them to come, maybe to a good treat.
Yes. Good girl.
Good, I'm gonna turn around and go this way now. See, a little less focused here. It's okay though, she's moving.
Yes.
I want to be very consistent on acknowledging paying attention to me. Remember, leash walking is simply paying attention to you while moving. Let's try and do a real life leave it. See how she's fixated on the ground here? Here.
Yes.
So there's an example of the leave it, look at me combo right there. Leave the grass alone. Look at me. Here.
Yes. Good girl.
Very good. Here.
Yes.
And this is what you'll do when you encounter things that they won't leave alone. All right, so I'm gonna see if I can keep the walk advancing towards the fence here.
Come on. Come on.
Come on, look how reluctant she's being. So I am coaxing her with the treat,
yes.
Good, what's this? Look at me. Yes. I wanted to kind of transition that focus on the treat up here to my face a little bit. See, here she's like saying, okay, I want to go over here. But right now we're doing a lesson, so we're going to try and keep her focused on me so we can continue on the way that I want to go. So now we're seeing tension on the leash. Let's go back on the pavement, see what happens. Much better. Here.
Yes.
Check out that sustained attention through this left turn. Good. Come on,
look at that, isn't that interesting?
I mean, dogs are sensitive to surfaces.
Come on, let's go.
Look at that, that's weird. She's doing really well on not biting her leash right now. I like that a lot. Really like this, here you go.
How many of you deal with this with your puppy? They just lie down and they don't want to go. Pretty normal for a puppy. I think this was a good introductory leash session for her. We'll continue to work on it and see how she does. You know, I couldn't help but introduce Kona to the Frisbee right here. She's been watching Inertia play and she seems to be kind of interested when we're out here goofing off with the Frisbee. When you're getting your dog interested in a new toy or Frisbee, the first thing to do is to make it really interesting. Sometimes that can be a little tougher with a thing like a Frisbee. There's no squeaker on it. You know, it's just a piece of plastic. And right now I'm just trying to spark the flint here, just trying to get a fire going. And you can see it's a little tough right now. She's not in the most Frisbee-minded point of view. So we'll keep trying on that and see if that interest and that drive intensifies over time. The idea is to get her tracking it while it rolls on the ground, just like that. Good girl. Maybe we can get her grabbing it. Really, we're just trying to increase general interest. You don't just create a Frisbee dog by throwing the Frisbee and hoping for the best. The idea, we're really trying to, yes, good girl, yeah, look at that. Trying to get her to grab it by the rim, good. I wanna get her really comfortable grabbing it. Of course, she's got those puppy teeth, but she's got a good tug. Really good tug for a puppy. There you go. Get it, good, yeah. And I really want to come to life and be exciting when she does that. A little keep away. Dogs like to play keep away even when you're the one keeping it away from them. Of course, they often like to keep it away from you too. Good, come on, let's go. There we go, yeah, good. By running from her, I'm encouraging her to chase me, which should transition into her bringing a fetch toy back later on. You want to be very conservative when you're exercising a puppy. See, there's things called growth plates. They're kind of like soft parts at the end of really long bones in young dogs, which allow the bones to become longer. Now, eventually those growth plates will close, and that can take anywhere between 18 to 24 months of age. With a puppy, about 5 minutes per month of age twice a day is a general guideline for how much you should exercise them. So a 3-month-old puppy would exercise about 30 minutes a day. So avoid things like really long walks or other super repetitive exercises with young dogs. Now for a dog like Kona, free play can be very valuable. That might mean playing with other dogs in the household or running around and just playing chase or playing with their new favorite toy. Basically, just letting your puppy do their own thing. And when your puppy naturally takes a break, just let them chill. See how she was going for my shoelaces? I was able to redirect her under the Frisbee there and chase it instead. These days, it seems everybody is having their pet food delivered to them, right? After all, it doesn't really make sense to go in public too much during a pandemic when it is so easy to have your food sent straight to your house. Consider setting up automatic pet food delivery at PetFlow. Choose your dog's favorite food and tell PetFlow how often you want it to arrive at your front door, and it will be there whenever you need it. Enter code ZAC30 when you check out and you'll get $10 off your first 3 automatic shipments. I'll have all of the details below. And pick up your Furbo dog camera too. I'm gonna have a link below. Subscribe to my channel to learn everything I know about dog training. Follow us on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok and get a copy of both of my books. We'll see you in the next video.